Well, hey guys, and welcome to my guide to playing support. So it's just support in general, the position, the role, support. In this guide, I'm going to talk about everything that is required to be a consistent support player and to play your champions efficiently. So this isn't any individual champion, it's not any specific individual. It's just anybody that watches this video can then learn the information that is required to play the support role, or as far as I'm aware. So let's talk about the perks of playing support, because believe it or not, there are some benefits to playing the support role. Shot calling is one of them. Being able to help your team to success is a key factor in the support role. By securing objectives such as Baron, Dragon or turrets, to setting up ambushes by pinging brushes and pink warding them or sweeping. So basically, in terms of this, you would think it would be your junglers to call Baron and Dragon. Well, no, not necessarily. When I play support, I'm always pinging for Drake, I'm always pinging for Baron when I think there's an opportunity, or I'm pinging for turrets. If they go 5-man squad right to the top lane and kill your top laner and kill him over and over again, you want to punish that every single time. You want to tell your team, you know, if he gets jumped on again, we're going to go up mid lane, we're going to take mid turret, we'll take the second tier as well, and then we'll continue. So it's really up to you to communicate with your team, so that is a big factor in playing support. Another thing is, you're not CS reliant. You don't require an upkeep in CS to get your items. You sustain through your masteries, items and, you know, passives, stuff like that. So that's another big beneficiary, because some people will start League of Legends and they'll be like, hey, I cannot CS properly, I can't keep up with the other person because they've been playing a long time and I've just started and I can't do it. It's good to then just go into the support role and then watch how people play the ADC role or different roles and watch them farm properly, because as a support, you can sit there and you can gain gold off your passive, your items, such as I said, and you can make plays happen just by, you know, being there and having a presence in the game. So that is another thing to keep in mind. You also play without risk, right? This is obviously, it depends on which champion you're playing. If you're playing squishies such as Janna and stuff like that, then you are playing with a bit of risk. But if you're playing, you know, chunky people, such as Blitzcrank, Nautilus and stuff, I'll go over that in a second, but relatively speaking, it doesn't matter if you die a lot, because it's normally good for the support to sacrifice in order for the team to get kills and snowball the game, again, depending on the champion. And someone like Alistar, who is an all-in factor, and once he's in, and he can only sustain for so long, then he may die, and that is just unfortunate. But at the same time, you might get the knock-up and stuff, and then your team will get a pick and get ahead, and it's worth you dying, because you don't need kills to basically get your cash in League. You get through your items and stuff. So that's a few of the perks. I mean, there's a lot more, but like I said, I want to keep this video pretty short, so I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next topic. So the next topic is, so what champions should I look to pick up when starting support? Now, I've got 4 champions here, and I think these are the best champions to pick up as support, and I'll explain why. So the first one is Blitzcrank. He was the first champion that I picked up when I came to League. His kit is very easy to understand. If you hook a squishy target, the fight's normally over in 1. He's relatively easier to understand. Like I said, he's got his hook, he's got his W, which speeds him up, and his CE is a knock-up, and he also has a silence that's on relatively low cooldown. So Blitzcrank is a very easy pick. He's very easy to understand, and most people hate him because, you know, Blitzcrank, oh my god, that's a bronze pick and stuff like that. A good Blitzcrank player, it doesn't matter what elo you're from, you know, if you can time that hook, you can judge people's movement and stuff, you can become a really good Blitzcrank player. I mentioned him before, but Nautilus as well, because he's so strong in this meta right now, and he offers so much CC and tankiness. Nautilus is an absolute god in Season 6, and that should never be underlined. If you want to climb, pick Nautilus. Another champion that's really similar to Nautilus but doesn't offer as much as he does, I think, is Leona. Leona's kit is very basic. She's also, like I said, she's very tanky and similar to Nautilus. She's a really all-in champion once you get that Zenith Blade on someone and your stun and your shield. So Leona is another really good pick to pick up. And the last one is a sort of utility-based champion, because I was looking at the different aspects of champions. So Blitzcrank has his hook, Nautilus also does, but he's really tanky. Leona is an all-in champion, and then you have Soraka is my last pick. She's basically the safest pick in this game as a laning phase. If you want to play super passive and you're not sure what to do, Soraka, keep pressing W, healing your ADC and watch him trade with enemy team, watch him kill people, you know, as long as you keep those heals up, you're not going to have a problem. She's very passive and is really easy to understand. That's basically the gist of Soraka. And I've also got a guide for Soraka and Nautilus, so I'll include that in the description below. Check it out if you want to. I think Soraka got updated a little bit, so I'll need to go over that very soon. But for the majority of the time, she's pretty much the same. As for Leona and Blitzcrank, I'll still do a little guide on them, so that'll get done in the future, but that's totally irrelevant to this video. Warden is another subject I want to talk about. It's really simple, yet people like to make it sound difficult. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up the Summoner's Rift on the screen just now. I'm going to circulate the areas as relevant to what I'm speaking about. So if you're looking for aggressive wards, this is what you would do. Now I'm going to do it for both sides, so I'll give you a little bit of time to look and see. Once these are done, I will include them in the description, so you can download them and you can download the image and then say, oh hey, okay, the wards need to go here, here and here, and then you will know for yourself. So you're looking at aggressive wards just now, and this is where I would put them. I'm going to give it just a quick couple of seconds, then move on. And if you're needing defensive wards, here are the locations you should look for. Objective control such as Baron and Dragon are as follows. And finally, keeping your bot lane safe is relatively easy to understand as well, and that'll pop them into the brushes just now. So that is basically your wards. Like I said, I'll keep them in the description. If you want to download them, download the imagery. I'll just upload them straight to our image website so you can get them as quick as you can and you can see them in depth more for yourself. So another thing is how to itemize correctly. Now there's no real answer to this other than to judge the different team composition and understand yourself what you will need to protect your team. So this is challenging your judgment as a support player, as well as enhancing the knowledge of the game for yourself. So if you're against an all AD comp, again I go over this in my guide, so if you want to check out my guides, go on my channel. A bit of a sellout moment there, okay? Examples is an AD comp, you're going against an AD comp, you want to build armor and health, okay? AP comp, you build health and magic resist, right? And you probably take items that would protect you from that, whether it's bursty and stuff like that. I'm not going to go into great detail, but that is just a few examples. Masteries. Over time, you will understand which champions require what type of masteries, and some are very similar to each other. So instead of looking on Google for that guide for, I don't know, Morgana and Mobafire and stuff like that, how about taking the time to understand your masteries, because they're very simple to understand. And as a support player, if you understand each of the types of masteries you can use, you can utilize each individual mastery tree to maybe try something new on a champion. Experiment, who knows, you might find a build that is even better than the guides that are already out there, or you'll find a guild a guide that works for you best or better than what is on offer. Another thing to talk about is runes. Runes come hand in hand, everybody's different. In order to understand which runes you would need, you'd set up your different pages to go against different compositions, such as going against a majority AD comp and having one AP threat. You would take, off the top of my head, scaling magic resist and take more flat armor. If you're going against an AP comp, you take health and flat magic resist, as well as scaling armor. So the ones that aren't going to be a threat, you'd scale, because then you go into late game, and the ones that you're going to face early doors, early in the game, you take flat. That's basically as simple as that. For your matchups, now this is a key factor as well. Different supports obviously counter each other, and it's up to you to define which supports you can and can't play against. I mean, just because it says the opposite champion counters you doesn't mean it's necessarily true. This all comes down to individual playing ability, because as a support, it is your job to problem solve the situation and make it work regardless of the opposition. It's fairly straightforward here. It's a skill matchup all the time. Don't worry about, you know, if you're a Thresh and you're against a Leona. A Leona against a Thresh, if you engage with Leona, he'll flay you. All you need to do is play around that flay and you can make plays happen. It's as simple as that. Morgana Black Shield as well. There's loads of different examples that you can use. It's up to you to define when you make the plays or when you shouldn't. When you play passive, when you play aggressive, stuff like that. I go over these in my guides normally anyway, so if you're looking for a champion, just be on the lookout for that. So that's all the points, relatively speaking, covered. I hope you've enjoyed this, guys. I hope it's been informative for you. If I've missed anything, do let me know and I'll do my best to get back to you, okay? So thank you for watching, guys, and I shall see you in the next one.